Hey folks, it's James here. I thought I would go through some of the various formats on the TV. I'm filming this in the highest quality I can, so I don't have long because it takes up a lot of camera space, that. So I'll be quick brief. So I'm just going to put on a couple of picture quality ones. So we'll start off with DVD. Let's have a look at the War Games DVD. I haven't put that in 4K yet, that'd be good. So we'll look and see. See what it looks like. What's going on here? Okay. Gotta turn the sound down a bit. Put the sound down a bit. And just let's have a look at the quality. Is DVD still watchable on this TV? I'll just play it for a minute. Probably better skip him through the titles, aren't we? Again. I wonder why it's doing it in that square format. I wonder if that's just the best they can do it. Right. It's watchable. It's watchable. But why would you watch that when you've got the Blu-ray, is what I would say. Let's put the Blu-ray in. I'll pause it while I'm doing it. Now the Blu-ray picture is definitely much better, but you can still see the film grain. And you can still see bits, but it's pretty good. Much better, it's obviously in a much bigger format than the other one. Yeah, you're not going to watch the DVD when you can watch that, are you? I don't think so anyway. But the DVD still has its uses. So I'll take that out as well. And I'm going to put on one of my Blu-rays that I think is probably one of the best transfers. And that's The Tower of Inferno. So let's have a wee look at that. In all honesty, I think The Tower of Inferno is one of the best Blu-ray transfers I've seen. And looking at it on this TV, I'm still agreeing with that. Let's just pause it and zoom on to another scene. I want to see a bit with a fire. He says as he kind of gets to zoom. Picture quality is really, really good on this. I think that's enough before I get copyrighted. Saying that, a bit with the fire just came up. That should do. Nice picture. Now I'm going to show you the scene from Yellowstone that's on my Plex. That ultimately, when I first turned this TV on and seen this, what a picture this is. Absolutely incredible picture. Now, this is 4K with HDR from my Xbox One S. I don't think it's producing the absolute maximum you can get from it from a 4K disc, but the picture is really, really good still. Absolutely amazing. I'm just going to pause it for a second and I'll get to the beach scene. Not quite the beach, but he's fallen in. I don't know how this is going to show this video through my phone, but I'm recording it in the highest quality I possibly can. Right, that should do ya. Now, this is Star Wars. And it as you can see, it's showing in Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos, which my player is not capable of at the moment. But the picture and the detail on C-3PO is absolutely incredible. Look at the, I can see the beads of sweat on Luke's. I never even noticed that C-3PO had that dent in his head in that scene. I'll pause it and I'll get a space scene for you as well. Hopefully this should be a space scene coming up. Let's turn up the volume a bit. Don't think I've ever seen that better. So I've turned the TV off for now. That was just a few examples of what I've been playing about with over the last week. And I hope this video uploads and you can see the quality. I think you'll probably really need to watch this video on a 4K screen to see the quality. So if you have got one of them and you can put it on your TV, then it might be worthwhile. So once again, thank you very much for tuning in to the Movie Mad channel. Hopefully you've enjoyed those examples. I've certainly enjoyed looking at them. And you know what? Unless a movie hasn't got a Blu-ray release, am I going to have to retire the DVDs? Something to think about. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you next time.